Coral is closed down as crews drill a pipe under the Caloosahatchee River. This work is part of the Caloosahatchee Connect project. It's going to move reclaimed water from Fort Myers all the way into Cape Coral to keep the canals full in the dry season. NBC2's Claire Lavazoria was live from Horton Park showing us what's happening with this latest part of the project.
This large purple pipe right here is slowly but surely being fed from where I am here on Everest Parkway through Horton Park, deep under the Caloosahatchee River, to the city of Fort Myers. It is 7,500 feet long, and that is nearly a mile and a half. Just imagine that. This is no small project, but it will make a big impact on bringing more water to the growing city of Cape Coral.
It didn't take long.
I mean, you have these loud sounds. I mean, this is continuous.
For Sandra Smith to tell us why she's looking forward to the completion of a major pipeline project just steps away from her front door.
This particular pipe showed up about a week ago.
After about a month of drilling 100 feet under the Caloosahatchee River, the PVC pipes snaking along Everest Parkway.
Well, this is progress.
Are being carefully pulled piece by piece.
I'm anxious to see how smoothly it goes under the river.
Through Horton Park, under the river, and out the other side, where they will tie into the city of Fort Myers South Advanced Wastewater Treatment Facility.
We believe it will be a new world record for fusible PVC that is 24 inches in diameter, but we don't have Guinness out here today to verify that.
This portion of the Caloosahatchee Connect project is shutting down Horton Park for a few days because of all of the heavy machinery. That includes the popular boat ramp, which will be off limits through the 25th. Utilities director for the city of Cape Coral, Jeff Pearson, says once finished, the pipeline will provide up to 12 million gallons of additional reclaimed water per day for Cape Coral, something that will keep canal levels up during dry season. Pearson says the pipeline will also remove over 50 tons of excess nutrients from the Caloosahatchee and offer Cape Coral a more sustainable water supply. Neighbors living in the construction zone like Smith just hope all the dirt, dust, and digging pays off.
Hope it's almost finished. We're at the end now.
The utilities director says the entire project, not just this pipeline portion here, should be complete by this December. I am local in Cape Coral, Claire Lavazoria, NBC2.